Thanks for joining this particular session. So I'll be copying question one by one from the Excel to Notepad. So if you know the answer, you are ready to, you can give the answer. So we will, I'm copying the first one and you read yourself. If you know the answer, you are good to give. So static call and dynamic call, what is the best? Suppose I declare a program dynamic, will be creating load module dynamically every time it calls.
Hello.
Hi Venkat, Shraddha this side. Can I take this question?
Yes, why not? Please.
Yeah, so I think it depends on the requirement. If your program is undergoing frequent changes, then dynamic call is better. And if your program is not expected to edit frequently, then static is better, as all the load modules are linked editor together.
Yeah, thanks.
That is what I feel. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, next, second answer.
Yeah, so static call is better because it is having faster access. But if there is less changes, so in the module, so in that case, static call will be given more preference compared with dynamic call. But if there are modules which undergo frequent changes and where we need to compile the module as well along with the main module, so in that case, dynamic call will be better. So that recompilation of dynamic call is enough. So depend on the requirement, we can choose.
And third answer, particular. Please. Third answer.
Sorry.
No, no, I'm asking third answer.
Okay.
Yeah. Can I give Abhishek here?
It should be team. The answer should be vary when you compare the previous answer. So don't.
Yeah. This is okay.
Go ahead, Abhishek. Go ahead.
Okay. So two things are very important, which I already covered. One is frequent changes. Second is accessibility, and the runtime should be less and compile time in static call. But the most important thing is reusability. When you need reusability, then static call is better. You can make some functions as part of COBOL module, and you can keep it somewhere. So in case of reusability, static call is not very much useful. Dynamic call will be useful in that.
Okay, yeah,
thanks. So Venkat, we are more concerned about second part. I guess first part is very known to everyone. The second part, So I guess everyone, when giving the answer, they should at least listen to other answer and then only reply. Everyone knows first, then there is there is waste of time discussing the first one. The second half is difficult, so better is discuss the first, second half.
So anyone want to answer? Okay, this part, right? Anyone wants to answer?
I will go with the second answer. So the dynamic call does not create a load module every time.
Okay. So team, you are always good to respond if our colleagues' answers are wrong. Okay, if it is wrong answer, you correct. If you feel that it is convincing, that's all. No need to respond. So going to the next question, I hope, shall we go with this flow?
So Venkat, hi Kunal here, Venkat. Venkat, you want to answer this question, or we are just going to discuss one question, then three answers, and then we'll move to the gem question, next question. What is the strategy that we are following right now?
What you said last, that is correct. Okay. See, answering, I told you. So one person answering is not an easy task. So better, since that is the reason of the main reason to conduct the session. There are so many people are involved in joined, right? So everyone can give their views, their experience, right? So we are going to get three answers for each question, and three should be totally different. Yeah, that is okay. So this is the strategy we are going to do it. Yeah.
What is the last answer for last line? Suppose if I declare a program dynamically, will it be creating load model dynamically every time? So answer is no, it does not create.
Ishan is going to answer. I guess Ishan only answered earlier.
Won't create every time. It is like just the smaller load module will be picked, like dynamic calls, it will be picked every time, but it is not going to create every time.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah. Move on.
Thanks. So anyone wants to answer anything on the second part? One more answer you can. Right. So this is altogether, this is actually impact and impact assessment. So anyhow, the question came into the picture. Let's take three answers in high level. So when you are increasing the length of the field in one of the master files, what are your impact assessment? Any good to answer?
Yeah, Venkat, I can answer, but let other finish, then I will conclude.
So team, answer should not be a generic for all the questions. Okay. Oh, no answer here? How come?
I'll try to answer. So suppose if you are increasing length of a field in one of the file, then we have to check where this copybook is used. Then we have to check for all the COBOL modules. And along with that, if we are using EasyTriffs, then we have to check if any EasyTriff we need to change. Others can also add. Yeah.
Hi, Venkat Kunal here. So I think they are just increasing the field in one of the master file. I think they're not changing the copybook. So I think if there is any change in the length of the file, we have to refer the JCL, okay, where we have declared the file, else it'll record mismatch. I think return code, I think 39 will going to happen, where record length mismatch will going to happen. Okay. Also, if any, because based on that, the downstream, if this file is going to use in downstream, also there'll be an impact on that. So I believe if it is a single tone module, if it is in change in the increase in the length, you have to make sure that the same length is referred in the JCL and a subsequent downstream. This is what my understanding of this.
Yeah, I will just add it. In case we have used some working storage variables, right? Based on this, then the impact analysis for the programs also has to be done and changed accordingly. That's what I feel that also need to be done.
You're sorry, your voice is cracking. Hello.
Okay. You're able to hear me?
Yeah, it's better.
Okay, 1 minute. No, what I was telling is if that field length is increased, one of the field, in some of the COBOL programs, if we have declared some working storage for some calculation or something based on this field, then those programs also need to be modified. That depends on the impact analysis.
Okay.
In addition to that, suppose if that copybook is used, or suppose that field is used in one of the palm cards in any steps of the JCL, so we need to check out for that also, because it might be required changes in the palm card as well. Otherwise, the step get abandoned.
Venkat, to add to the point, we also should ensure we also check that in the linkage section if we are just making a call using that as a key.
Okay, so can I go to the next one?
Yeah, Venkat, adding on to the previous answers.
Yeah, Abhishek here. Okay, you go ahead. Yeah,
if that field is being moved to another field, like which is part of another copybook, for example, if you're changing the length of a field from the input file, if that field is being moved to another field of another copybook, so we need to take care of that field as well. Like that field can be moved again table or any output file. So in that scenario, even second copybook needs to be changed.
Venkat, I will add it. Here, whenever we change a file, so very important thing is we need to see how many component we are using this file, like JCL, PROC, your COBOL program, copybook, control card, so everywhere. So wherever we are changing any copy or anything, so we have to make our impact analysis through that way. In COBOL program, the only way we can give through the JCL, right? So we have to use our search for or any scan, how many components are affected through that particular file. So that's it. So wherever the impact is there, we have to correct it.
Okay, yeah, thanks. So there is one question, just I will show, and no more discussions on this for your information. Yeah, so the question is also in high level, one or two words on this, because most of them knows inspecting without the inspect. So in that context, it is very important when most of them are not aware. So you are good to give the answer.
By using length function.
No, it's not correct. Wait, see 1 minute. Okay, length will give you the total, the size of the variable. Let's say if you declared a variable with X of 35 store India, obviously it will give 30 only. But we want 5 characters. The length is what now takes 5. If I change it to USA, it should give 3. So that is the question you can consider and give me the answer.
Venkat, we can do one thing. We can use string, and we can in the string we can give WS count, right? We can count it how many variables, like character.
Okay. Next. Second answer.
We can reverse the string, and we can count each characters. We can remove the leading spaces. We can remove the leading spaces, then count the actual letters. Characters.
How to remove the leading spaces?
Yeah, in inspect we can do that. Inspect that string.
That is the question, right? Without using inspect. Without using inspect.
Venkat, I want to answer this question. It's very simple. We have one function of COBOL, string with pointer. So from string with pointer, we can check the length even for the space or string, whatever we want. So it's a best way to find out the length.
Okay, last final answer.
Just a blind shot, I'm not sure on that, but what I understand, like LRECL having for variable files, it is having some length, which is the largest record, correct? And block size contain the 8 more byte for that. So just a blind shot, like if we can, from block size, if it is given -8, it might get the length of the variable largest record or something without doing anything. Just not sure is correct or not.
Okay. Going to the next one. So guys, are you okay with this flow? Because see how many people are satisfying by the answers. You know, satisfying everyone is 100% difficult, but at least what is your view? Is it okay? The flow?
Venkat, I need answer for the question to once again, please.
Hey, we'll go back. Okay. See, once we are next to the question, we cannot go back. So please, okay, I will give you the video access. Please watch. Don't take anything negative.
Sure.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Venkat Srinivas here. The flow is good, but we are not confident that your answer will be correct or not, right? Like so many answers we are getting from the user.
See, no. That is a, okay, I don't know whether you start. I said initially also, Wait, Srinivas.
Initially,
I told that if you're strong and you're confident in the answer, you give it. Otherwise, we'll go to the next question. So we are having 101 participants here. So we should get exactly the top three correct answers. Okay. So if you say, yes, I have a confident answer, you tell that, yes, I have a confident answer. Okay, you can tell that word. We will try to take it that. Yeah, next, see the question. So it's simple, but go with the two answers, I guess.
Yes, it's actually this question. I think it should not be here because it's a very simple question. Link and edit. These are the part of any .txt file or any runnable load model kind of. So compilation is the part. Okay, and link edit is required. So simple, it's required. And also it is. Actually, it is for accessing the COBOL libraries and like metadata. Metadata we can access through link edit only. So that's it.
Venkat, can I add to it? Because at the compilation, we just get only the object code, and only at the link edit, whether we use HEWR or IEWL, it will be converted into a machine instructions or machine level this thing. So link is required. So answer is both.
Venkat, same question I have been asked in the interview, but instead of link, it was asking for bind. So I think the answer will be the same for both the cases.
Come again. Instead of link, they asked
whether they have done the changes into the COBOL part. They have not touched the DB2 part of it. So only compilation will be for you to bind also for that. So recently I've given an interview, so in that they asked me the question. So answer in both the cases is that we need both.
Okay, good to hear that.
Yeah.
I want to give the last, in my training session, I have done one training from
one thing I want then, to, one.
Abhishek, hold for some time. Let's give chance to others. Okay, you have to hold for some time. So yeah, next others.
Yeah, I want to speak. I have done my training from Mainframe Institute. There we don't have an Endeavor or tool, so we are using one program for compile IGY, CRCTN, or HEWL for our thinking. So we need to do because we don't have a sub program or internet written normal program.
Okay. Next question. Everyone go on mute. Okay. If you're not answering. So I hope one answer or two answers for this.
We'll contact the DBA for that.
Scheduling team, right?
We can schedule that on that particular day.
We never schedule the jobs. It's a scheduling team who schedule the job, and we just have to give the input to them. Yeah.
Correct.
That is so, correct, right?
Yeah, correct. Because obviously, right? Scheduling team, scheduling tool purpose is only to schedule for future dates also.
Correct.